first things first is a piece of Wrigley's PK chewing gum. It looks like there's about 4 pieces left in that pack. And there we go, best before 24th of October 2023, so well in date. And yeah, see if I can push out a white piece of PK peppermint flavoured chewing gum. If I haven't said this before, this is my favourite chewing gum. So I'm going to pop that in my mouth. This is my wireless keyboard and mouse that I use with my laptop. I was actually thinking to myself that I was going to have to spin that round to read it all. When you spin it around like that, then that's the right way up, and then you spin it around again and the writing is the right way up too. This device complies with part 15 of the B. I know it's the FCC rules. Operation is subject to the following 2 conditions. This device may not cause harmful interference, and this device must accept any interference received, including interference that may cause undesired operation. Okay. Switzerland. Netherlands branch is in Netherlands. Okay. I wonder if anybody's taken the time to read the small print on their keyboard. I certainly haven't until then. So I was just watching My Name is Earl and Darnell has a turtle that he calls Mr. Turtle, and so that was the idea or the inspiration. I wanted to call this brush Mr. Brush. Pretty clean, this keyboard. Anyway. somebody said in one of the comments recently, in the last few days, we haven't done a keyboard video for a while. Keyboard brushing. So I thought, yeah, I should do it. Surprisingly popular, the last two keyboard brushing videos, and no real sort of great preparation. I just have to produce a new keyboard or another keyboard. There's a little switch there, and that turns on the keyboard. I can see the green light came on then. There's a couple of batteries in the back, just in there. Is it like a... Oh, there we go. Two double A's. That I've looked in there before. You know, even though spin that back over, even though you know you use the keyboard and the mouse all the time, the batteries last for ages and ages. I think it's still the original battery there too, in the back of this mouse. So there's the mouse, two clickers left and right, and a wheel. I'll turn that on as well. It's on. Inside the mouse there is the little wireless sender switch. Plug that into your keyboard. Ah, no, sorry, laptop in the USB port, or your PC. Wait a few seconds, and suddenly the mouse and the keyboard work. Now with this this little sender, it's tuned into both the mouse and the keyboard, so you know you can't well, it's best not to get them mixed up, otherwise you'll have a keyboard that doesn't talk to your laptop or PC. Okay, it's back in like that. This is a nice clean looking mouse, but I'll give it a bit of a brushing anyway. That's an interesting, it's a different sort of a plastic. It's more of a rubber on the side and more of a hard plastic up top. I was going to say then, I've just lost my train of thought. had something else. Nothing much on the bottom. Oh, there we go. This is an M310T mouse. Here's a part number and a, it's even got a serial number. And which is interesting. Is that a, can't see that. No, I was thinking for a second that's a QR code, but I don't think so. Or maybe it is. It could be. Not really too sure. But anyway, it's got a couple little feet, all four actually. Little feet on there. A couple of clicks. Interesting. So yeah, I look at this little piece here. This is a little bit of plastic, and I'm sort of tempted to take it off, but then maybe it should stay there. I think it's causing all that shiny bit around the keyboard. It's like a big section under all the keys. Well, not these keys, but in around there. You probably should take it off, I suppose, but it's sort of coming off like that. But I don't think I will. I'll leave it there. Keeps it nice and shiny. Yeah, I don't know whether if there's anything interesting in the keys, that is. These little, oh, okay, I hadn't really noticed those before. That's a rewind, pause and play, and fast forward. Okay, and there it's got mute, and that's, oh yeah, there we go, volume down or quieter, and volume up or louder. That's funny, really, because, you know, you're sort of used to the keys that you use all the time, but if there's any sort of special keys on the keyboards, like in this case, I've never noticed those before, even though I use this keyboard. A lot. I use it with my laptop. I don't really like the little laptop key. It's a bit fiddly. I enjoy the big regular keyboard keys, and the separate number pad is always useful as well. One thing I was going to point out, now that I saw my hand, if you look there, I've got a distinctive little red, not very noticeable, but a little red spot there that's been there for a number of years. The freckles kind of come and go. That's the red spot there, so all your skin. And I'm sure I've showed that to him in the past. It's nothing to worry about. What usually happens is sometimes I have big sort of chunky moles that I look at and think they look terrible. There's got to be something wrong with them, but he often doesn't say there's nothing. I'll start saying that again. He usually thinks that they're fine, but it'll be some inconspicuous little black mark, little black mole, that I think doesn't look too bad. He'll look at in great detail. They sometimes take sort of biopsies, yeah, I guess the word, yeah. Puts a needle, a deadening needle in, takes a little bit out of the core, and sends it off for analysis. It works amazingly quickly. You're sort of in and out in maybe 10 or 15 minutes, and you start, a full scan of all your skin. You leave your undies on, of course, you've done a biopsy or two and written a few notes, and away you go. I was given this cream, you see, and I had to rub it into my forehead so many times during the week. Might have been every day, every night, I can't remember. And nothing happened for ages, but I kept going with it. And then suddenly, after a number of weeks, it all bubbled out up on my forehead in a big sort of a crusty scab. Eventually healed, and the basal cell carcinoma was gone without really any surgical, cutting of my forehead, so that was quite amazing. In Australia we have public health, Medicare. Universal health care, I think, is that what it's called, maybe, I don't know. So everybody has access to a doctor. You can go to the doctor without paying. Some doctors charge you a bit more and you skin doctor. I think my out-of-pocket is about $40. Medicare pays some, and I pay some. It's it's quite a good. I think it's a good arrangement. So if you've never worked, never paid taxes, as long as you're an Australian citizen or permanent resident, you've got access to the universal healthcare. Its faults, but it's quite good. That's funny how I'm talking to you about that. This is a keyboard video with brushing, Mr. Paintbrush. Thanks for watching.